Before I get out of here, I just want to talk about some of my heroes. You know, I talked about Michael Jordan earlier. Michael Jordan was the fucking man, yo. And people always talk about LeBron James is better than Michael Jordan, or is Michael Jordan better than LeBron James? And I mean, it's just so ridiculous because they're both, they're champions. I mean, there's nothing you can do about that. They're both champions. Now, why do we have to particularly put someone's championship into question based off of someone else who is an equally great champion? And when we used to get that Wheaties box, I mean, that's how we really saw champions. I mean, you were, you know, professional basketball player, you know, Earl the Pearl, you know, everybody, you know, I mean, all those old school guys who came before the Wheaties box, we still respected them. But once you got on that Wheaties box, it was like you became like royalty. And there was nothing you could ever do to change our vision of you once you got on the box. And I'm talking about Michael Jordan. I'm talking about Mary Lou Retner. I'm talking about Jackie Joyner Kersee. I'm talking about Serena Williams. I mean, I'm talking about once you get on that box, there is nothing you can do that will ever change our perception of you as a champion. Never. Bruce Jenner was on that box. He was on a Wheaties box. And nothing Bruce could ever do could ever change our perception of him. Nothing. He was a champion. He wanted to win. He's going to win. There's nothing you're going to do to get in Bruce's way. You'll never outwin him. Never. He's that competitive. And as we watched him on that show that he was on with the family that he is a part of, we started watching a man, at least from the public view, it looked like a man was deteriorating. A man was breaking inside. But maybe he wasn't breaking inside. Maybe what he was doing was planning a massive, massive victory. Massive. Because when you think about it, we all thought he was crazy. We said, well, Bruce is losing his mind. When he was in the corner, he had the hoodie on, he had the drawstrings drawn. He was losing his mind, and we were like, man, those Kardashians, they did it again. They're doing it again. They done fucked up Kanye. They done fucked up Lamar Odom. They done fucked up poor Scott. I don't know Scott's last name, but you know White Scott from the show? He was a good man. He bought that fucking Kardashian girl a fucking SL McLaren, and she fucking got an attitude when she saw it and didn't like it. This is the kind of people you are dealing with. This is the kind of shit that Bruce was dealing with. And as we watched him lose his mind, we said, Bruce is crazy. He's going insane. They done it again. I mean, they got me scared to death. If Kim Kardashian stormed in here right now, butt naked, and said, Dice, I demand you fuck me right now, backstage, right now, we are going to kill you, I would have to think twice about it. Because I'm that afraid. I'm that afraid to what the Kardashian pussy could do to me. I'm petrified. I've seen what it can do. I've seen what it's doing. And we thought Bruce was crazy. Because if a person, I mean, typically, if a man ran in here right now and grabbed a knife off a table and said, I want to cut my dick off! I want to cut my dick off! We would all grab him and tackle him to the floor so that he didn't hurt himself. But if he walked into a hospital and said, hello, I'm looking to make an appointment for Wednesday. And these people say, yeah, sure, well, what would you like to get done? And he says, well, I like to get my dick cut off. They would say, oh, well, I think we have 12 p.m. available. I mean, since you said it so calmly, you know, that's clearly not a sign of mental illness. I mean, you just said it very nice to me. But if a person's screaming it, we think they're crazy. But if they just mumble in it in a very nice, soothing tone, I would like to have my penis cut off. 12 o'clock Wednesday afternoon. Is that available? Yeah, we can do that. We can, yeah, sure. Why not? Yeah, we can do that. But I started thinking that poor Bruce was dealing with some sort of mental illness. And I'm not saying being gay is a mental illness, because I don't believe that. I believe that people are born gay, and it's a thing that happens at childbirth, and it's just a natural thing, just like anything else. You know, like a man liking a woman is the same as a man liking a man. I mean, for some people, you know. But Bruce's thing was, he's like, nah, I'm still going to fuck chicks. And it's like, wait, what? You want a sex change, but you want to be a lesbian? Like, it was just weird. It just didn't make any sense to me until last night, when I realized that Kylie became the first billionaire makeup line. That's when it hit me. Bruce is not going to be beaten by anybody at any game, track or field, basketball or football, baseball or golf. And if your game is the pussy game, well, fuck it. He ain't gonna let you beat him in that. And Bruce Jenner has risen to the stakes of the pussy game, and he has become King Pussy. And the Kardashians are dealing with it. And Bruce, I say, he has made an amazing comeback, something that we have never seen before, and it should go down in the history of the Sports Hall of Fame. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good night.